I know they are. Michelle Padgett, Prophetess Michelle Padgett, and then we have Apostle Beverly Freeman on the live broadcast with us. So before we proceed, I want to guys ask you, please take a moment and share this video on your Facebook timeline. And I believe some of you are that who are watching right now, maybe you'll be blessed. And you never know who is in your friend list, probably needs to hear this powerful word. So that's the reason we ask people to share so they can hear this powerful word and be blessed by this inspiring, encouraging word. So here all the way from Texas with us, both great women of God's, honored to have you guys. And we're going to start with, first of all, Apostle Beverly. Please take a moment and introduce yourself.
Hello, everyone. It's great to be on here. Thank you, Apostle, for inviting us tonight. Thank you. Appreciate it so much. I am a apostle of intercession. I believe that my heart is more to teach people about prayer and intercession. And that is my heart, is just to teach people they are soldiers in God's army. Teach them about the armor of God, how to pray, how to take dominion in the earth, submitting ourselves to God, resisting the devil and the enemy willfully. And we have to understand that in Psalms chapter 8, God said that he has given us dominion in the earth. And it is our responsibility to release the kingdom of God on earth. And I teach people who they are in Jesus Christ to believe that what the word of God says they are, that's who they are. And to walk in faith. I'm a big faith person. And I really believe in decrees and declarations and legislating from you're seated with Christ Jesus in heavenly places, and you war from a place of victory that has already been won by the Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen. Praise the Lord. And then we have Prophetess Michelle Padgett. She lives in California, right? 3 hours behind. But now she is 2 hours, 1 hour, I think, behind in Texas. Currently she is. So Prophetess Michelle and I known for a while now, and I have seen her ministry growing, and God is actually doing amazing things in her ministry. But currently she's in Dallas, Texas. And here over to you, Prophetess. Please take a moment. Tell us the people that who are new to you. So tell a little bit about yourself.
Sure. Again, as Apostle said, thank you, Apostle, for bringing us on tonight. And this is actually, Beverly Froman is my spiritual mother. And yeah. And again, my name is Michelle Padgett, Prophetess Michelle Padgett. I'm from San Diego, California. And I am a prophetess to the nation. And so I do a lot of ministry in nations as well as here in the United States. I have a signs, wonders, and miracles ministry, as well as healing and deliverance and prophecy.
Amen. Yeah. Praise the Lord. So, guys, since you are in Texas, I know New York is on the top. I wanted to talk about that, you know, with you guys. New York is over almost 50,000 cases confirmed in the coronavirus. How's the things going on in Texas?
I think we have around 700 cases the last time I checked. I haven't looked in the last couple of days, so it could be much more, mostly in the Dallas area and like Houston, like the, you know, the big cities, along the I-35 corridor and the I-45 corridor. Seems to be a whole lot more cases there.
Yeah, so there's a people like whole entire United States, not just the United States, but the world is panicking, and people are staying home. A lot of churches are not, you know, doing Sunday services, and people are sitting home. So, Apostle, I wanted to ask you, what do you probably? It's new for all of us. So, what is your observation where we are, and when we talk about people are panicking, and what people should do to stay motivated, stay encouraged, and stay inspired?
Well, I know at intercession 2 weeks ago, I began to see visions of a brain, just brains, you know, people's brains. And I was like, God, you know, what are you trying to say? And the Father was trying to show me that people's minds would be attacked by a spirit of fear, that fear would try to, you know, just really take over people's minds. Even the body of Christ has had to fight fear. And, you know, I've had to fight fear as well, because the media has really just broadcast negativity. I'm not saying the virus is not serious. It is serious. But God is greater. God is great. We're to keep our eyes on the Lord Jesus Christ. We're to keep our eyes on the fact that the Lord said we are healed. We are to walk in divine health. We're to live in Goshen. And the portion that is on the world, that's not our portion as believers. And we are to be lights in the darkness. I believe it's Isaiah 60 time for the body of Christ. Yes. That we are to rise and shine and be a light in the darkness. And then in the world, people that don't belong to Jesus walking in peace, they can say, you know, they will say, well, why are you in such peace? Well, because I know the peacemaker. I know the Prince of Peace. I know Jesus, and I know that I'm covered. I'm under the refuge of the Most High God. And I am, you know, I want to invite you to come into the refuge of the Most High God with me and be saved and be healed and be delivered. I'm not saying that, you know, this virus won't touch any believer. I'm not saying that. God will help us to get through this situation we are going through. And we have the victory. Stay in faith and not fear, because I believe fear is a landing strip for the enemy. And it activates Satan like faith activates God. This time is so critical for the body of Christ to keep that whole armor of God up on themselves and stay in faith, talk faith, and try not to watch too much news. Watch enough to stay informed, but put the word of God in front of your face and stay in your prayer closet.
Yes,
we are submitting ourselves to God, resisting the devil and the enemy willfully in Jesus' name. We're believing God.
Amen. Praise the Lord. So there is a, we got a question from somebody, Amber. She asking, do you think that this is close to the end? So I'm going to first of all take your thoughts, Prophetess Michelle, and then we will come back to Apostle Beverly to, you know, further take her thoughts on that question.
Yeah, I actually believe in my heart that God is waiting for his people to, you know, as in 2 Chronicles 7:14, I really believe that God is really wanting his people to humble themselves, get in their prayer closet, as Apostle Beverly said, get in your prayer closet, pray, seek the face of God, and allow him, get into repentance. Repentance, I believe, is the key that we're going to see humility. This breakthrough. Yes, when we all humble ourselves in the sight of God, that that he is going to raise a standard up when it comes to this coronavirus. But he's waiting on the people. God is waiting on us to do our part.
Yes.
And so it's up to us to come into agreement, alignment with what heaven already says about us and about the plans and purposes that God has for our lives.
Yeah.
Come on. Come on. Wow, praise the Lord. And further thoughts, Apostle Beverly, could you please share, do you think we are to the we are close to the end time?
Well, the way the word of God is, I believe that we're seeing prophecy unfold in front of our eyes of end time warnings. No man knows the day or the hour, but I definitely believe that we're getting close to that hour. I believe that we are in a season where we definitely need to know what time it is and what season it is and put on the armor of light and be ready.
Yeah.
Be ready. Be ready.
Yeah. Amen. So, Jesus, when his disciple asked, how would we know those days, you know, when you will come back? Jesus said exactly what it is, not the, you know, it does. Nobody knows yet. I'm going to paraphrase that. Nobody knows, nor the angel, but God. You know, Jesus himself didn't know about the, you know, end day. But I strongly believe that, you know, as you know, when the storm is coming, you can just tell by, you know, by how the weather is. And, you know, the clouds and, you know, and all the rainings and lightnings. And you can tell it's going to be a big storm or tornado or anything. But I just believe strongly in my spirit that, you know, we have to be more even speed up than ever before preaching the gospel to the four corners of the earth, you know, because that's what you're commissioned to do it. And I'm pumped up. I'm excited because with all that technology Christians have, they can do a lot. And, what we're doing right now, you guys in Texas and and I'm in New York and interviews being done. This is incredible, right?
Praise God.
Amen.
Awesome.
And God is doing a lot of things. So tell us about your ministry, what you're passionate about, Apostle Beverly. You know, how long you've been in the ministry and what's God been speaking to you?
I have been a prayer intercessor for about 30 years, and every church that I go to is usually a church that is being built. It's a, you know, like a brand new church. God will send me to these little young churches, and I come alongside and help build the churches. And I guess, you know, that is the description of an apostle, to come alongside and help build, you know, the church, and teaching people prayer. I have been an ordained minister since 2010, called into the ministry and preaching the gospel. So praise God.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. And it is really my passion is just, you know, see people coming to know Jesus Christ as their personal savior. And we've been doing, you know, ministry in Pakistan for over 11 years, and God actually been doing amazing things in Pakistan. And one of my heart is to plant churches in Pakistan.
Amen.
And not just in Pakistan, Prophetess Michelle and I spoke about that, not just in Pakistan, but all over the world. And she got the same vision. But how can we effectively, those people that who are gone away, how or been disappointed, how can we win them back over to Prophetess Michelle?
Love.
There we go.
Perfect love. It's perfect love that casts out all fear. That's what the Word of God says. And, you know, it's up to us to win the souls back by the prodigals, to win the lost, the broken back by love. We're never going to win them back by beating them over the head with the Bible, but we are going to win them back by love, by spreading unconditional, agape, sacrificial love.
Yes. Yes, I agree.
Amen. Praise the Lord. That is great. I think love is one of the big, like Corinthians 13, you know, talks about love and, you know, and as you mentioned, because a lot of people out there are hurting, you know, a lot of people out there that who've been disappointed or been gone away for a long time. But I believe it's time for people to return because we are heading towards the end of the time. So this is incredible. So here, Apostle Beverly, I think you were going to say something.
Oh, no, not really. You just go ahead.
I thought you were like,
I'm agreeing with you. Totally.
She's in church right now.
Hallelujah.
I just said,
praise the Lord.
I said, amen.
Okay. All right, that's awesome. So continue, people who are watching right now, please continue to share this video. I see Amber is on. She is sending a lot of messages and also asking. Praise God. She got a lot of questions. Guys, listen, towards the end of this show, we want to pray for you. We want to pray for a breakthrough. We want to pray for, you know, whatever the situation you're going through. We don't know, but the Spirit of God does. And God wants to bless you, heal you, you know, and deliver you. But you have your faith, because often people have faith in their life, but they don't utilize it. But I'm going to talk both of you. Faith is right now, I believe faith is one of the biggest weapon we have, you know, to keep on, continue going on. So same with the issue of blood. The lady had, you know, had an issue of blood for 12 years, but as soon as she touched the hem of Jesus' garment and she was healed. That's a very popular story in the Bible. So right now, a lot of people out there that who are hurting, that who are afraid what's going to happen, I want you to know that we have faith. That's the greatest weapon we can use against the devil.
God. Yes.
Amen. Amen. So tell us, you know, both of you, you can feel free to pitch in. Don't wait for my question. If you think that something you think that needs to be shared, please pitch in, because a lot of the many questions that I will be asking you, you know, And if you guys, you know, if anything that you see from a different perspective, you guys can feel free to pitch in.
Okay. Absolutely. Yeah. I'd like to start, Apostle. I just really feel, you know, like I said before that, you know, 2 Chronicles 7:14, that not only just that, if you read that whole scripture, you know, we must walk in obedience.
Yeah.
We must walk in obedience to what God wants. We must be able to hear what the Spirit of the Lord is saying in this very hour.
Yes.
Because if we do not hear what the Spirit of the Lord is saying in this hour, we're going to miss it. So my heart is that people will learn to get into that secret place and be able to really lean into the heart of God and hear exactly what the Father is saying in this very hour for his people. Because what has happened, you know, I was sharing earlier, I had a vision. And in this vision, you know, I get a lot of visions.
Yeah.
A lot of dreams, a lot of visions, a lot of visitations. But in this specific vision, I saw a very large tower.
Yeah.
And on this tower, I thought it was the Eiffel Tower. And I looked closer. And as I looked closer, I could see it was labeled. And different parts of labels were on it, had different things. Like one said Hollywood, and it had like superstars, like stars in Hollywood names on it. And one said basketball, you know, American basketball, and had different Lakers and this team and that team and so on and so forth. And at stars' names and football stars and Disney companies. And corporations, Coca-Cola, you know, big corporations, and these names were on this tower. And I said to the Lord, like, what is it? And the Lord said to me, this is the become the American idol. These are the American idols.
Yeah.
And I said, oh, Lord. And I was watching, and I started watching the tower begin to start to fall. And when this tower started to fall, I was watching as the labels were coming off. I said, God, what is going on? What do you want to say to your people in this hour? And he took me and he said, what does it say in my word, beloved? What is my first commandment?
Yeah.
Thou shall have no other gods before me. Meaning a god, a little g god, is an idol.
Mm-hmm.
And he wants us to have no idols. Nothing that will stand in between our relationship and intimacy with the Father right now in this hour. And he told me, he said, not only have those idols become American idols and the idols of the American people, but these have also become the idols of my people, meaning all across the world. So God, I believe in this hour, is tearing down the idols. He's tearing down the idols of Hollywood in this things that are not of him. And he's humbling us. And he's humbling Hollywood. And he's humbling the stars. And we're going to see, I believe, some major things, some major shifts that are getting ready to take place. We're getting ready to see some big things that are getting ready to fall.
Yes.
Because he is not going to stand anything standing in the way of his name being raised up in this very hour.
Hey,
come on, right. Praise him not. Now you're talking. Hallelujah. I just feel the anointing of God. Wow.
I feel like the harvest. As the harvest comes in, we're getting ready to see those in Hollywood and even those who have, because I believe that we're getting ready to see the great wealth transfer. Because it's going to transfer from the wealth of those who are on that tower.
Oh.
Those who were on that tower,
I'm gonna read some.
Those were idols. And God said to me, big dollar signs were on there. And I watched as it fell to the ground. And he said, no man shall get the glory.
Amen.
No man shall glory.
Can I read something, Apostle? I'm going to read something out of the book of Haggai.
Sure, please. Okay.
Hallelujah. Okay, where's my... Okay. Yeah, 2. Okay, beginning with chapter 2, verse 6 in the book of Haggai. For thus saith the Lord of hosts, yet once more in a little while, I will shake and make tremble the starry heavens, the earth, the sea, and the dry land. And I will shake all nations, and the desire and the precious things of all nations shall come in. And I will fill the house with splendor, says the Lord of hosts. The silver is mine, and the gold is mine, says the Lord of hosts. The latter glory of this house, with its successor to which Jesus came, shall be greater than the former, says the Lord of hosts. And in this place I will give peace and prosperity, says the Lord of hosts. The glory of the latter house shall be greater than the former house. Hallelujah. Amen. And the latter rain is pouring out. It is beginning to pour out. And it's going to increase and increase and increase. Posture yourself in a place of faith right now. Look to God for your provision. For he is your provision. Not man. That's not right. Your job. That's God right. Himself That's is right. Your provision. Your shepherd. You shall not want. He will make you to lie down in green pastures. He'll lead you beside the still waters.
Yeah.
Yeah. We're walking through the valley of the shadow That's of right. death. But we're not no going fear. To fear evil. For God is with us. His rod and his staff. The Lord is preparing a table before us in the presence of our enemies. The Lord is going to anoint our head with oil, and goodness and mercy will follow us all the days of our life. That is our portion.
We're
going
to dwell in the house of the Lord.
That is our portion. Forever. If you remember, when the plagues hit Egypt, when Moses went to the Pharaoh, he said, "Let my people go." And Pharaoh's heart was hardened, and all those plagues hit the Egyptian. The whole nation was ruined because the man would not bow his knees to the Lord God's desire.
Come on.
And it was ruined. The nation was ruined because they would not submit to the Lord. And that is a wake-up call for us right now. Absolutely. Submission. We need to submit to the Lord. But my point, too, in this is the children of Israel lived in Goshen. And the plagues did not hit them.
That's right.
Come on.
And the blood of Jesus was put over the doorpost. That's and right. the plague passed over them. And isn't it strange that right now it's time for Passover? Get up and put the blood over your doorpost and everywhere you go and over your family. That is your responsibility to take dominion in the earth and access all that God has given us through his precious blood.
Yes. Amen.
Amen. Wow, that's powerful. Oh wow. I just feel anointing of God, you know, just hit that place, because often we are afraid, we are panicking, but not realizing that because God is bigger than Corona. God is in control, totally in control. No matter where you are, and no matter who you are, he is in control, and he has a total control of this thing. You know, but those of you that who don't know Jesus Christ, I want to invite you to receive Jesus Christ as your personal Savior.
Yes,
because when you have the blood of the Lamb, because Jesus is the only way to heaven. And Jesus, the blood of Jesus, if you have on your doorpost, on you are protected by it. It's going to pass over you because Jesus got you covered. You might not be covered with insurance right now, but if you get covered with the blood of Jesus Christ, you're covered. Amen. That's hallelujah. Right
there. The blood of Jesus.
Whether you have insurance or not, but if you just get the blood of Jesus on you, by the faith of our Lord Jesus, you'll be saved in Jesus' mighty name. So, guys, as the prayer requests are coming in, I want you to guys take a moment, pray for people, pray for healing, pray for those that who lost their loved one, because a lot of people, you know, who were diagnosed with coronavirus are dead, and you know, and a lot of people recover, and I'm grateful for those people who are recovered. But the people that who are, you know, gone, a loved one, lost their loved one, let's pray for them as well. So I'm going to ask both of you, well, let's pray. And I really love, the people right now that who are going through hell and hot water, but they're still trusting the Lord. They're still believing that God is not giving up on them. So you should not give up on God as well. So here, over to you guys.
I was getting a word of knowledge there, Apostle, as I was sitting there. I saw a vision of a young man that you don't know Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior. And And young man, I believe you are in the Middle East. I believe that you are in Pakistan. And I see you have been filled with fear, that fear has tried to grip you, that fear has tried to grip your family. And I say that tonight is your night of salvation. Tonight is the night that the Lord is reaching out his hand over the airwaves right now. And he's saying, come to me.
Yes.
Come to me and I will give you rest. Come to me. Yes. For yes. I am your Savior. Yes. I am the Lord and yes. I am your Redeemer.
Yes.
And if this Amen. Pertains to you, we want you to just reach out. Yes. And Bev, I just want you to pray for the people right yes. now. Just pray over the people yes. right now. Wow, I feel the presence yes. of God
come on.
Right now.
Father,
fear come down right now in Jesus' yes. name. Yes.
I just release the perfect love of God where there's fear, mm. that it will be displaced by the perfect love of God in the name of Jesus.
Come on.
And Lord, that their hearts would be in peace, God. I pray they would learn to keep their eyes focused upon you. You will keep in yes. perfect peace.
Yes.
Those whose minds will stayed up on you. We are to exalt the name of Jesus right now and not this virus because That's God right. is greater. God is greater. God is greater. Keep your eyes upon Jesus.
Come on.
And not the statistics about what this thing is doing. It is bad, but God is greater. God is Come greater. On. And I pray the comfort of God over people right now. And any place where there's blinders and on any lost person out there, I pray the blinders come off. Any
yes.
deafness on ears, yeah. I pray the deafness goes off.
Yeah.
Any place where there's a hard heart, I pray the circumcision of God will come,
come on.
And
come on.
Circumcise the hard heart now
yes. Yes.
in the name
the
of Jesus. Too. And I speak to the prodigals and I say, come home now. Come home, run to the mercy seat. Run to the mercy seat, for the Lord will give you mercy yes. and grace. Favor, life is in his favor. He favors life over you. And I
Come
pray
on.
The Zoe life over people right now.
Come
the
on.
Abundant life of God over people. Oh, Jesus, we thank you for the blood. I appropriate the blood. I appropriate the resurrection power over people. They will be encouraged, that they will be strengthened by the power of God in Jesus' name.
And for anybody out there, if you don't know Jesus as your Lord and Savior, yeah. right now, we really want to just bring you in to the kingdom. Yeah. We want to say, welcome home.
Come on.
Welcome
yes.
home. There is nothing that you can do that will ever separate you from the love of God.
Yes.
Nothing. He loves you so much that he's put you on this broadcast for a reason.
Come on.
So that we can reach out to you through this broadcast. So that you can come home
yes.
and that you're marked by the blood of Jesus. You're marked by the blood of Jesus. And if that's you right now, I want you to just reach out right now to the screen right now as we're going to pray for you.
Yes.
Just say, dear Jesus,
come on.
Come into my heart. Be my Lord and Savior. Lord Jesus, I'm a sinner and I need you. I need you right now yes. in this time, in this hour. My family
yes.
needs you. I need you in this time. Lord Jesus, please come and save me. Set
yes.
me free. Set me free from me.
Yes,
set me free from religion. Set me free from the things that are not going to save me right now. And I ask you right now into my heart to be my yes. Lord and to be my Savior. And from this day forth, I'll serve you all
yes.
the days of my life.
Come on.
Yes. And we pray yes. for a baptism of fire and
yes.
the Holy Ghost
yes.
on anyone that accepts Jesus. They will not only be saved, but the baptism of fire
Come on.
And
yes.
the Holy Ghost baptism now in the name of Jesus. Don't let's
yes.
take them all the way in.
Yeah.
Come
yeah.
on. Let's
yeah.
take them all the way in. Baptism of fire and the Holy Ghost. Ask the Lord for it. The Lord will bless you with it if you ask him for it.
And right now you might be feeling like a burning sensation all over your body. That's the baptism of fire.
Come on.
That's the holy fire of God. He is purifying you and making you whole, healed, delivered, and set free right here over a broadcast.
Yes.
This can reach to the four corners of the earth. And right now, we're just calling all prodigals home now with no fear, but by faith.
Yes.
By faith we call you in right now. As it goes, and it ricochets, it goes across the airwaves right now. I see it. It's just the waves and waves of God's glory.
Yes.
Going over the airwaves right now into your homes, into your workplaces, into everywhere that you've been hiding, even that God is saying, it's your time.
Come on.
This is your time to arise and shine.
Arise
and shine. And I see the Lord right now marking people. He's going around the earth and he's marking people with the blood.
Come on.
It's the blood, like Passover. It's the blood. And the enemy will not touch you. He cannot come near your dwelling place if you have no open doors. And right now we close, seal, and burn every door to the demonic in every part of your soul right now. Your mind, your will, your emotion, and every part of your body right now. We call the holy fire of God to fall on you in every system in your body. From the top of your head to the soles of your feet, we say align. Align with your divine destiny, align with the purpose and the plans that God has for your life in Jesus' name.
Yes. Hallelujah.
And hallelujah.
I read a decree. If that's okay, I want to read a decree over the people right now. I release the voice of the blood of Jesus against every evil spirit, over every evil spirit that accuses, condemns, and brings bondage and oppresses. I release the voice of the blood of Jesus. Let the blood release freedom and speak a better word over the people in the name of Jesus. I decree freedom from bondage, from addiction. I decree freedom from fear. I decree freedom from loss. I decree freedom from all of those things that would rob, steal, kill, or destroy. For Jesus has come to give us life and give it to us more abundantly. And I release the blood of Jesus for the people to bring them into Zoe life and into the good shepherd's arms in Jesus' name.
And right now we just call you out of the prisons. The prisons that you place yourself into, the prisons that others have placed you into. I call forth anybody who's being abused right now to come out right now. You are not a victim. You are not put on the earth to be used and abused. But God says it's your time to arise and step into the fullness of all he has for you in Jesus' name.
Wow. Amen. Jesus' name. Amen. Wow, wow, wow. So powerful prayer. Thank you so much for both of you and the words that they have spoken in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ. To take this word, and I agree, because the Bible says where two or three agree by name, and whatever they bind on the earth, two people, it will bind on the heaven. And in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ, we bind every single thing that is against us, against our prosperity, against our growth, against our health, against our children. Bind every single thing in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ. And God, we come before you, before your throne, and we bow to you. We honor you, give you glory and worship to you, because there is no other God like you. You're a Lord, you're Abba, your Father, you're a healer. You're our defender, you're a protector, you're a redeemer, you fight for us, God. Even the enemies around, it seems like we are surrounded by the enemies around, but God, you will help us cut them down, God. You break the teeth of the wicked, and the backbone of the wicked will be broken, but we will trust in the God's unfailing love, because his loves never fail. And God, we will trust you, we will lift our eyes to you, because the Bible says Psalm 121, where does my help come from? My help comes from the Lord, and I will not see left or right. I will not trust in any man, but I will trust the Lord. The Psalm 118 says, verse says, it is better to take a refuge in the Lord than to trust in the man. It is better to take a refuge in the Lord than to trust in the princes. God, we will trust in you. God, we will look to you when we feel like our situations, our condition is going down. But God, we will lift our eyes to you, because we will ask you to, God, come for our defense. Rescue us, God. We can't do it on our own. We are trusting in your mighty power. God, may we trusting in the light of your face. And wherever we go, may the light of face, the God's face may shine in our ways, in our direction, in Jesus' mighty name. We pray, we decree and declare anointing of God shall increase over your life. And wherever you are, wherever you're watching from, in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ, we pray blessing over you and over your family.
Yes.
And we also pray for those that who lost their loved one. May God give you comfort and peace in Jesus' mighty name. And also who are recovered, we also celebrate them in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. And if you did not receive Jesus as your personal Savior, and if you recovered, I invite you to come to know Jesus Christ as your personal Savior in Jesus' mighty name. Whatever we ask, we receive by faith. Amen.
Amen.
Wow, that was powerful, guys. And I'm very glad to have both of you, and I'm looking forward to connecting with you, Prophetess. And it's very good to connect with Apostle Beverly. I'm looking forward to getting to know you more, and let's connect again.
Amen.
Yes,
sir. Thank you again. Blessings.
God bless you guys. Have a beautiful night. Thank you so much for coming.
Bye-bye.
Bye.